At least about 54 stacks of damage looks like against the boss. 71,000 damage, not the biggest hit in the world, but still pretty satisfying. I'm told there's a new enchantment I need to know about, and that enchantment is called Dynamo. Adds damage to the next attack after rolling. So let's try and figure out exactly how this works. I roll once, that should have added 1,000 damage. I roll again, that must be another 1,000 damage. 3 times, so if I hit this thing now, 6,700 damage. That's very interesting. So let's try a 15 times hit. 22,420 if I read that correctly. So provided I'm allowed to stack this endlessly, we could do some pretty big ridiculous damage. So next, let's try a 50 times hit, but also with a strength potion, a shadow potion, and then we're gonna try the gong, but I think that's gonna undo the shadow potion, but whatever the case, there's a hit for 1.4 million. This is gonna get fun. My first concern though is I'm hitting with a jailer's scythe, which only does 2,000 damage. With a different weapon, we could be doing potentially 3 times that damage, so we would have done almost 4 million there. And interestingly, I do already have a level 115 doom crossbow with dynamo. It does 4,200 base. So that could be fun too, but I kinda wanna hit with some kind of big melee weapon. That was 55,000 damage that easy though. So for now, I'm simply gonna spend some time trying to grind out a high damage weapon with the right enchantment on it. I need dynamo, because you really can just never have too much damage. And wouldn't this be something? A unique broadsword level 110. If that had the right enchantment, this might actually be the perfect weapon for it. I'm almost scared to look at it. It's weird to think that an idea like this might not actually take me 10 hours to do. And it doesn't have the enchantment I wanted. That's 4,000 damage though. And I am gonna start with the secret boss because it's the fastest to get to him and he can drop the claymore. Plus there's just something satisfying about killing these things. And just an exploding crossbow. So for the time being, I'm gonna try and upgrade this a level or two to hopefully get just a little more damage out of it. Then I'll just kill this idiot 3 times really quick. 1, 2, and 3. We got 3 crossbows, but at least one of them was unique. Albeit not particularly useful. But with that, the blacksmith has finished my scythe upgrade, so hopefully it's still just 112. And that's still okay, 112 is plenty strong. I can always gamble too, because you never know what you're gonna get. If we spend 300 emeralds on a sword, we're gonna get a spear, which actually could have some damage to it. And this one, 110. The nice thing is that for once it doesn't need to be a unique, we just need the one enchantment, that's all we're looking for. But let's put the scythe right back in, and we're gonna try that again, 3 more missions. And then we can do things like our daily trial, because that will potentially reward us with a unique melee, at least rare. That might be good. The challenge on this one is game over if anybody dies. I need to stay alive. So as long as nothing catches me and corners me, I'll be just fine. And I'm mostly gonna do this through every single level, except when there's a chest. I do want the loot, but I do need to stay alive. And that's also where my bow comes in handy, because it does a lot of damage to a lot of enemies, but that's why I can't stop. For example, starting to realize that I might have to put on my good armor at some point anyway, because things can one-shot me if they hit me cleanly. One crossbow is enough to do it. Alright, we're doing it the slow way. It's really not that slow considering I just walk through basically all of the enemies. I just can't run through it at full speed like I'd like to. And this way I am guaranteed the chest opening. That chest had a trick bow. A sleek bow that seems to never miss its target. I think this is the one that bounces around to multiple targets, and look what it has. So if I say roll 15 times and fire an arrow, it hits a whole bunch of things. Not all of them, but it hit a few enemies for 15,000 damage or so. I was hoping it would hit more than that, but I can still add multi-shot to that, and that could be fun. As if it fires 5 arrows that hit lots of enemies, that's gonna make it easy. Oops. Maybe we'll try it here. 33 times damage buildup. I was hoping for a multi-shot. It still did a lot of damage to a few of them. Situations like this could be fun if it would ever fire a multi-shot, because look at all the enemies it could be hitting, especially these big annoying idiots. I don't think I've ever killed a loot pick in one shot. You think 10 times is enough to do it? Oh, 13,000 is still pretty good though. Those pigs have a lot of health. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna open his door, fire 20,000 damage of arrows through it, and hopefully kill everything, because hopefully it's a multi-shot. Ready? We'll do 21,000. And go. It was a multi-shot. Oh, it didn't even kill everything. That's weak. Those enchanted creepers sure hit hard. I've just realized I'm probably going about this the wrong way anyways. I'm trying to find a higher damage weapon when I'm just adding 1,000 damage per roll anyway. The base damage of the weapon doesn't really matter. So, could I have my scythe back? But maybe we'll get lucky from this guy, one more melee weapon. It does have dynamo, it does have critical hit, but its damage isn't really anything worthwhile. The scythe is gonna work, I just need it back from the idiot. Anyways, since I need to finish 3 dungeons now, I'm gonna do Soggy Swamp because it can drop the unique scatter crossbow, which can potentially fire up to 25 arrows at once. And 25 arrows of basically unlimited damage sounds like kind of fun. So as I was running through this dungeon, I noticed something curious. That. So I took a second to look it up, and it turns out if you have deflect on one of your armors and start the damage going, it will deflect for that damage every time the arrow does deflect. So that's pretty hilarious. I've got 26 stacks of damage. That means if something deflects, it gets hit for 26 stacks of damage and my thing doesn't reset. So the more stacks I have, the better, but as it is, things are killing themselves by shooting me. And there's just something very satisfying about that. Watch an arrow fire back and absolutely obliterate that thing for 26,000 damage. This'll be fun. Look at them all. They have no idea they're killing themselves by doing that. Well, let's see what 54 stacks of damage looks like against the boss. 71,000 damage. Not the biggest hit in the world, but still pretty satisfying. Anyways, I'm gonna finish stupid off with my fists. And yes, that's what it sounds like for a glaive. Was really hoping for the better thing, but at least I finished the damn dungeon. I did find a unique after this boss kill, but it's just box armor, which does at least add a little bit of damage. Once again, my scythe is done. 112, so it didn't get an upgrade once again. That's okay, because we can still gamble from this idiot. And so far it's not optimistic. The flail might be something decent. Well, it is at least interesting. Double radiance plus critical hit, but not at all what we're looking for today. So we're just gonna go with the scythe. Because it's not really gonna matter which weapon I'm using, as long as it preferably has critical hit and I roll, it's gonna do a lot of damage after a little while. Naturally, we're gonna kill this boss because he's my favorite to torment. The first thing I need to do is get the right potions to spawn. We got the strength already, just need a shadow. And then I'm gonna roll for the next 80 hours of my life to get some ridiculous damage readout. I guess I could be starting that now while I'm waiting. I just don't want to roll too close to the boss and activate him. This is gonna take a little while to do, but at least I know I'm gonna get the result. There's guaranteed damage here. And the second potion has spawned. Now I'm gonna stand in this corner and roll. I'm gonna sit here and hit the spacebar until I feel satisfied, and it's gonna be a while. So far we're at 17 stacks. Each stack adds a little under 1,000 damage. 939. We saw a hit for over a million earlier. I want like tens of millions. Hundreds of millions potentially. I started timing this just for fun, and I could roll once every about 2.5 seconds. So that means 1,000 damage every 2.5 seconds. That works out to 24,000 base damage per minute, or about 1.5 million damage an hour. The big question now is, will this stack pass 99? I think it will, but sometimes there are limits to these things. 99 and 100. We're good to at least 999. Anyways, I finally got my macros working again, so now I don't have to do anything. My guy's gonna roll his way into the big leagues. So I'll see you all in like 4 hours. Hopefully the game doesn't crash. And we've officially crossed the 1000 mark. Starting to stack up quite a bit of damage. Do we think that 1200 damage stacks is enough? Well, it's never enough, but enough for now. I'm too nervous at this point that I'm gonna screw this up. But then again, when don't I screw something up? Strength potion? We'll maybe make the boss spawn and go back for the shadow potion. I'm already screwing this up. That's fine. We'll be able to hit him for tons of damage no matter what. That and kablamo! Didn't see the damage readout till the very end. What was that? Whatever the case, that felt good. Let me go back and read that damage. On review of the footage, that was about 32 million damage. Might have been closer to 33 million, but lots. And that kind of sucks in a way, because now I'm just thinking about, well, why don't we do 100 million damage? Or if I'm gonna go that far, just bump it all the way up to a billion. We've still got lots of work to do.